Dear sir, madam, lady, gentlemen, professor, and everyone here, today I'm very honored and happy to present my speech, Symbols Image Deconvolution Based on Reverse Image Convolution and Backward Progression Algorithm. I am Professor Dr. Ngọc Nguyễn and founder of Ngọc Nguyễn Academic Network Việt Nam. This is my email and my home base. And I am very honored and happy to make the connection with all of you. Thank you very much. Abstract. The convolution task is not important in convolution neural network CNN because it is not imperative to recover convoluted images when convolutional layer is important to extract features. However, the convolution task is useful in some cases of inspecting and directing a convolution filter. AI is trying to improve a generated image when information loss is not serious with regard to track of information loss and specific features such as edge detection and sharpening. This research proposes a duplicated and reversed process of recovering a filter image. Firstly, short layers and target layers are reversed in accordance with traditional image convolution so as to train the convolutional filter. Secondly, the train filter is reversed again to define the convolutional operator for recovering the filter image. The reverse process is associated with backward progression algorithm, which is more popular in learning neural network. Experimental results show that the robust techniques in this research is better to learn the filter that focus on discovering pixels difference. Therefore, the main contribution of this research is to inspect convolution filter from data. Table contains one introduction to methodology, three experimental results and discussion for convolution. Introduction. Convolution operator are convolution products with its main operator of convolution neural network CNN does not imply any degradation because it plays the most important role of extracting features of image. However, in some cases, it is not necessary to make a so-called deconvolution operator, which is the opposite of convolutional operator, in order to recover original image. Especially deep generative models may need to reinterpret the original image from the encoded image when encoded image was transformed by convolutional operator. In general, this research focuses on image deconvolution which is not popular in CNN area, but there are some typical research related to image deconvolution. Domain of single image super resolution, CR, which is not like the viewpoint of the research, focuses series on reconstructing high resolution image SR from low resolution image LR, according to Chow. At all, there are three types of CR. One, interpolation based approach focuses on calculating missing pixels of SR by interpolation equations on pixels of LR. Two, reconstruction based approach focuses on taking advantage of special aspects of SR such as region profile, edge feature, and non-local means in order to recover missing pixels of SR from LR. And three, learning-based approach focuses on discovering the relationship between SR and LR by comparing dataset of both SR and LR. Kim and Kwon, whose work is similar to this research, propose a regression method to learn a so-called resolution kernel of minimizing loss function between transform SR and LR and SR. Please pay attention that the resolution kernel, which is not traditional filter kernel in CNN, is a Gaussian filter function, but essentially, the resolution kernel is the kernel which is more complex than the matrix kernel of CNN. Actually, the resolution kernel is used to transform LR into an intermediate form which is in turn compared with SR. According to Chow et al., recently researched, which belong to learning based approach are applied in CNN into CIR where the transformation from LR to SR is represented by a deep CNN. Ken Ridley, Chow et al. Revolved a fully networking industry stage as a three-layer structure for image enhancement, such as non-linear enhancement, multi-scale feature restoration, and fusion enhancement. Moreover, Chow et al. Added Kunbeck neighbor diversion into loss function for improving CNN training process. In different viewpoints, author encoder AE domain, which is much similar to this research, considered the image deconvolution as a decoding process, decoder of encoded image, but there is the attention that AE is not variational autoencoders by its generative model. AE assumes that the degradation of decoded image is not concerned because AE tries to restore original image as well as possible. The AE deconvolution is expressed by following reparation rule here, where S is short layer whose bit cells are decoded, S is a Y is target layer deconvoluted layer whose bit cells are denoted Y. Fs is activation function, W is deconvolution filter, and B is deconvolution bias. Indeed, AE methodology is almost the same as this research when the filter W is learned by minimizing a Gaussian loss function, and bad preparation algorithm accept that the target layer in AE is not firmly accepted to be degraded. Works of Kochenko et al. And Sui et al. Are typical works in AE domain, but Sui et al. When beyond by transforming convolutional space into frequency space via Fourier transformation. In general, the aspect of this research which is different from other researchers is that I focus on learning convolution filter from two convolution layers so as to contribute a sub-filter to the convolution process, whereas other researchers focus on improving or keeping quality of image. Obviously, image quality improvement is much more important, but this researcher aims to a viewpoint of mutual relationship between convolution cost and the convolution cost, which attach to bad preparation algorithm. Moreover, degradation in image quality is obviously accepted in this research. Therefore, this research has two purposes: one, training convolution filter, and two, making the image deconvolution by trained filter. The trained filter is learned from the process of reversing image convolution, and the proposed image deconvolution is a reverse process based on trained filter two. Session 2. Methodology. Manager of convolution neural networks, CNN, is a convolution layer which performs convolution operator based on a so-called convolution filter, which is an NN square semantic use. Given a convolution short layer S represented by its pixel SIC, which are operated with filter U by the convolution operator in order to produce a target layer Y represented by a resulted pixel Y here, where Fs is the activation function of layer S and its derivatives is denoted F co is adversely in context of CNN. The target layer Y will obtain some aspect which depend on specific filters, which does not imply any degradation, but in some cases, it is not necessary to learn the filter yield from the short layer S and the target layer Y, and then make the image deconvolution based on the learned filter, which note that the layer Y is smaller than layer S in size. The trick here is to consider the deconvolution process as a reverse the process of image convolution. Exactly, layer Y becomes short layer, whereas layer S becomes target layer, and the convolutional operator is executed by N square matrix W as follows here. Please pay attention that layer S is now smaller than layer Y inside. Note that the convolution bias B is ignored without loss of generality in methodology in this research according to equation 1. Given Bissell et al.'s loss function of convolution process is where the notation, this notation denotes the Euclidean norm. According to Beck preparation algorithm, the filter W is learned by applying stochastic gradient descent to the loss function L. According to equation 2, rectified linear units is used a activation function in the result here. The execution of Beck preparation algorithm E is snit over the short layer Y by ln log by not that learning grade gamma larger than 0 and smaller than or equal to 1. After filter W is on the first purpose of this research is reached, and then the second purpose would be easier is to perform the image deconvolution based on the trend filter W. And repeat that after filter W is in on the first purpose of the research is reached, and then the second purpose will be easier to perform the image deconvolution based on the trend filter W. Because W is a convolution filter, obviously it cannot be applied into the convolution class. However, recall that the convolution process is considered as a reverse process of image convolution. The deconvolution class will be performed by reverse operator with the filter W, in which layer S and layer Y are reversed again in order to get back its original ground as a short layer and target layers, respectively a follow according to equation 3. Equation 3 is very important. If Y KL do not exist, it is said to be S as a smoothing trick. Therefore, until the convolution filter W cannot be applied into the convolution class, this result implies a duplicated transformation in order to take advantage of filter W for image deconvolution. Section 3, experimental result and discussion. The experiment is performed on the laptop with CPU AMD 64 for processor, 4GB RAM, Windows 10, and Java 15. The dataset is set up 10 oxygen images and 3 convolution filter. 3 convolution filter such as a null filter, subabundant filter, and edge detection filter are tested. After the convolution filter are executed, images cannot be recovered well except null filter, because filter images are seriously modified and 3 times smaller. Therefore, filter images are zoomed 3 times, which will be combined with the convoluted image revealed by the technique of reverse image deconvolution in this research. Exactly, let MA0 be mean of absolute error of a filter image and an original image, and let MAE be the mean absolute error of a deconvoluted image and original image according to equation 4. Where notation denotes the absolute value and is the number of images, number equal 10, and NI is the number of pixels of the ith image. Obviously, image IJ denotes the J pixel of the ith image, with not that image filter and image deconvolution are original image, filter image, and the convoluted image respectively. For a filter, a so-called loss ratio are between MAH and MA0 if compared. The smaller the loss ratio are, is the better the convolution class E according to equation 5. The test is done with 10 learning grades, gamma from 1 down to 0.11, because the stochastic gradient descent SRD algorithm is affected by earning grade. Table 1 shows MAE, MAE0, and loss ratio of the three filters with regard to 10 learning grades from 1 down to 0. 0.1. By summarizing Table 1, average loss ratios are listed in Table 2. Table 2. Average loss ratio of filters. From Table 2, it is easy to recognize that sharpening filter and edge detection filter obtain good results with small loss ratio, whereas detection is the best one, which implies that the robust reverse method is suitable to the convolutional filter that focus on discovering pixel different inside image. However, this improvement is insignificant because sharpening filter only keep most important feature with increased information loss. I repeat that, however, this improvement is insignificant because the sharpening filter only keep most important feature with increased information loss. For instance, given where the perfect edge detection, this is the perfect edge detection, the best filter estimation of edge detection whose average loss ratio is here, and nearly 1.6, with learning rate gamma equal 0.9 for color channels red, green, blue are here. It's easy to recognize that the estimated filter variety keep the robustness between weight. For instance, the ratio minus 8 is relatively approximated. However, the magnitude of estimated filters is 3 times approximately larger than the magnitude of the perfect edge detection. Conclusion. In general, the image deconvolution in this research is simple with only two convolution layers associated with bad propagation algorithm and stochastic gradient descent algorithm in the reverse direction. Therefore, the restoration result is not as good as single image super resolution (CR) and deep neural network in autoencoder (AE). But the main contribution of the research is to inspect convolution filters from together with mutual relationship between convolution and the convolution. In future gen, I will try to extend and improve the deconvolution process with deep neural network having more than 2 layers like AE did. This is a reference. Thank you very much for your listening and attention. I'm very honored and happy to answer your question. Many thanks all of you again.